guys, it's Beth here, and today is day 3 of our growth challenge, okay? The past 2 days we've been talking about what a brand is and what it's not. Yesterday we went over the fact that you already have a brand, whether you're crafting it or not, and today we're going to start crafting the brand that you have, okay? Another misconception that a lot of business owners, especially new business owners, have is that they should want to be for everybody, right? Their product, we talked about yesterday how business owners typically are super excited about the products that they have because they're there to help people, right? And so one of the things that we have to understand is that even though they can help people, we can't help everyone. You see, two people who market the same or a similar product are going to market to different people because they connect with different people, okay? Me and my best friend have a lot of similarities, but we also have a lot of differences, right? And so there's things that she could make profitable in her life that I couldn't make profitable in mine. There are ways that she could connect with some people that I couldn't connect with people like that because I just don't hold the same values and beliefs that she does. Not all of them, at least. Okay, so you want to think about who you can attract to you and what kind of values and beliefs you can speak to bring those people in, okay? You've got to have your own kind of appeal to people that will bring them in, and you can't be for everyone. You just cannot. Like, your brand is not made to be for anyone. It's made to be for the people who will connect with it, okay? And so sometimes that means being controversial. Sometimes that means taking stands for things. We're going to talk about that a little bit more tomorrow, but today we're going to focus on who you can attract, okay? So let's talk about a quick example from a new Netflix series that's out. It's called Self-Made by Madam C.J. Walker, or not by Madam C.J. Walker, but it's about Madam C.J. Walker, okay? And Madam C.J. Walker was the first African-American woman millionaire in America, okay? And she was super successful because, as we can see in the film or in the series, she was like great at branding and marketing, okay? Which you have to be great at branding and marketing if you're going to sell something, because you can't get your message out there to people without having that brand and that marketing capability to get your message out, okay? Now, let's think about, in case you haven't seen the movie or the series, okay, Madam C.J. Walker sold hair care products for African-American women, okay? And so her target market was obviously African-American, was mostly women. She would tell some ladies that their husbands could use it, but I mean, it was a woman's product, right? And they mainly went after women. So we are talking African-American, we're talking women, we're talking definitely strong-minded women and somewhat brave women too, I would say, because Madam C.J. Walker was iconic in her time, okay? She was somebody who stepped outside of almost every norm, okay? You know, women during that time did not have a real seat at the table, not like we do today, which, I mean, there can be struggles for us, but I mean, we have it way better than she ever would have. She went to men's conferences. She would get on stage to speak when she wasn't invited. She would stand up for what she believed in, and she would put her neck on the line for a lot of things, okay? And so when she marketed, she could be that person. And some people, they could use her as like their champion if they weren't brave themselves. But she definitely needed strong-minded and passionate people around her, okay? Those were some of the people she would have definitely brought in. Then she also did not want to follow common beauty standards. This was another way she was absolutely you know, like controversial. Her husband tried and tried and tried to get like the Walker girl started, essentially. And it was this like classically beautiful, tall, thin woman who could be on the front of their packaging. And she would kind of be their brand, and she would embody who her clientele wanted to be. And Madam C.J. Walker said, I don't want my clientele to have to be reaching for the standard of beauty that we set for them. I want them to love who they are. I want them to be the everyday girls, right? And we see this work really, really well today with companies like Dove and Aerie, right? Dove and Aerie both have these like Real Women campaigns where they don't retouch their photos. Their videos show a wide variety of women from different ethnicities, different shapes, different sizes, all of that kind of stuff. They show a wide group of women, and they make sure that they emphasize the like beauty in each, essentially the beauty that each of them has. Okay, so you know, when Madam C.J. Walker did that back in her day, that was a huge statement to make, right? To not follow along that classical beauty standard. She was super empowering to her followers, definitely empowering to us today. But also, she just, you know, she had a brand that she was not going to compromise for. And you have to have that too. Okay, just because somebody doesn't like something you do, they think you should do something differently, you are the one in control of your brand. And it's okay for people not to like you. You've got to be loved by some and hated by some, okay? Because that's what your brand is all about, okay? There are people who love a celebrity and yet they hate another celebrity. And I might love that celebrity they hate and hate the celebrity they love, right? But that celebrity's not worried about us. They're worried about who they're bringing in. They're worried about their loyalty of their followers, okay? I've seen this happen in teaching, right? Where there are just some kids that I will never connect with. I would try my hardest. And it's a lot easier for me being in a classroom with someone where I can physically interact with them than it is with us in business. So if I can have physical interactions with a child every single day for a whole 180 days, right? And they still don't change their opinion of me. They might be like, yeah, she's nice, but she's just not for me. Like, no, I would not want to be back in her class. No, I'm good. And yet they could be in somebody else's class and absolutely love that teacher. It's not like that they hate school or they hate all teachers. They just don't like me. They don't connect with me, and that's okay. Like, I'll have kids that I don't connect with, and that's fine. But we have to understand that we will have people in our business that will not like us, and we have to take those positions anyways. We have to have the values carved out that we want to show our followers so our followers will like and trust us, okay? Now, today what I want you to do is I want you to think of a list of like at least three to five values, attributes, qualities, or beliefs that your followers could have, okay? So maybe you start off real simply with whether you want to target like men or women, if you have a preference, okay? Maybe you want to think about like an age group that you want to do. Maybe you want to think about like a specific industry they're in, because if you're selling a product, you can always target like specific industry or specific hobby types or things like that. I mean, the narrower you can get, the better. But then also think about, don't forget, I want you to have at least like two values and beliefs that they can hold. Two things that they could connect with you personally on for more than just your profession, your, you know, age group, that kind of thing. So think about two personal beliefs at least, and then the rest of them could be general things about who they are, okay? Some of my beliefs that I have picked out in my clients that I try to focus on, I'll share four with you today. One of them is just that they're always willing to fail, and that every failure is an opportunity to learn. I fully believe that we fail. I know some people will like change the script there and say that like we never fail, we just learn and move on. But I think it's great to call our failures, because they make us realize that they weren't good, and they make us realize that we can do something better from them. It also promotes personal growth, which is one of my biggest things, is that we should always be trying to reach our next level, okay? Even when we feel like we've maxed out, like maybe we have, you know, our, like maybe you're a person who wants to have a lot of things balanced in your life. You want to have a balanced diet. You want to have a balanced like workout routine. You want to have a balanced like family to business lifestyle. You want to have like a lot of things in your life going smoothly, and you have all those things, and then you just sit around with those things. You always want to be looking for that next level. And if you're coming with me, we're always looking for that next level. We will always be shifting and changing our products. We'll always be jumping to new products, all that kind of stuff, because I just don't ever want to be stagnant. I'm not one of these people that just wants to take one thing and just make it the best thing. We will always be changing some as we go through and just growing and getting better every single time that we come out. Okay. A third thing is that time is precious and valuable. I once heard it called our only non-renewable resource, which is a little, you know, dramatic and extra, but essentially they were saying in our lives, we can replace all the material things. We can replace our money if we lose it, but we can't replace our time. Our time is the only thing we have. And for me personally, I am such a planner because my time in my day has to be scheduled out because I just don't have enough of it. So if I don't schedule it out, if I don't see what's happening and see how I can fit everything in, I won't get everything done. So I am a huge planner and I plan out everything, like to my social gatherings, to my bedtime, to every single thing in my life is planned to a T. And that's just the way I need it to be. And I want people who also have the same value for time. They may not have to be as crazy as me about it, but they also do understand that their time is valuable, and so is mine, and we don't waste each other's times. Neither of us. They don't waste mine, I don't waste theirs. Okay. Lastly, I just think it's so important to pursue personal education. It's like one of the most valuable pursuits that you can go in. Because you know, a lot of people will tell you what you should and shouldn't learn. A lot of people will have an opinion on like how you should learn it. And I just think that you have to decide those things for yourself. And anytime that you can invest in personal education, like even monetarily, you should do it. Like if you have some money laying around that you could put into something, like putting it into yourself is the best way, and put it like yourself in a more productive way. So buying a course, buying, like looking at a free information, reading articles, reading books. I'm like a big reader, and just I'm also a big reader of like books on tape. So I don't necessarily read, but I listen to people read to me. I love like Audible and that kind of stuff. And so, you know, these things are all really, really important to me. And I make sure that they're also important to my clients because I make sure to talk about those things. Okay. So I need you to make sure your list gets written by tomorrow, okay? Because tomorrow we're gonna be talking about the way we can put our messaging of those values into practice, okay? How we actually craft those messages to people to connect with those values, okay? And then just so you know, on Sunday, we're also gonna be talking about how we take those and make them into something that people actually want to consume. Okay, so we've got a couple steps building on each other for these next 2 days. So bear with me, make your list, come back and see us tomorrow at 5:30. Okay, we will see you then. Y'all have a great night.